Hello. In this video, I'm going to show how to configure sequence bars, to configure hotkeys for sequence bars. You can't set a hotkey that will just execute the sequence for you. That would not be very sporting. And it's something that Turbine specifically designs the Lua API interface not to support, so this video is not going to show that. What this video is going to show is using hotkeys to make bars appear under your mouse cursor, so you can click on them without having to find them on your screen. So, for example, the way I have it configured now, I can click one key and wherever my mouse cursor happens to be, this bar opens. I can click through the sequence, and then when I move my mouse away, it hides. And I've got three different bars set up, so when I click three different keys, I see three different bars. So the way to do that is go to your plugin manager, sequence bars. I'm just going to delete everything and start over and show you how I did it. So the first thing to do is to create your some bars that you want to control with hotkeys. And I just made up some random scenarios where I might want to do that. Ambush, self heal, rescue, and then you just add your skills to these bars as usual. I'm just putting random stuff in here that makes no sense. Okay, so now I have three sequence bars that you can use as normal. But I want to control them with hotkeys, so the first step for that is to create some events, user events, to control these bars. So I'm going to create another bar that's just, I'm just going to call it events, whose only purpose is to generate some user events. I'm gonna add some special slots here, generate user event, and just clone that a couple times. So for the first one, I'm gonna generate an event called rescue. You can name these whatever you would like, but I'm just going to, for simplicity, have them named corresponding to the names of the bars. So I've got three different user events, and then I need to set these bars to be controlled by the user events. So we've got to enable event behaviors and add show bar when user event occurs, rescue, and then hide the bar when either of these other two events occurs. Did I do that right? Let's see. Yeah. Okay, so Same thing for these other two bars. Show bar. The ambush event. Line bar. Rescue. Line bar, self heal. Okay, the last one. Show for self heal. Hide for rescue. Hide for ambush. Okay, so if I've done all that right, then when I click on this bar here, when I click on each one of these slots, it should show one of the bars and hide the other two bars. Let's turn off the animation there. Okay, so now I've got these three bars set to respond to the user events. The next thing I want to do is to assign hotkeys to those. So the way you do that is using the chat window here. I can generate any user event at any time with the SB event command. So if I want to generate the ambush user event, I can just type it here like this. And now you see the ambush bar appeared and the other two disappeared. Etc. And so the last thing I did was to create some aliases here, which I'm going to redo those, show you how I did them. Use the shortcut commands. This one is the quick slot number. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so forth. And then the numbers continue up. So I'm going to make it appear right here. And then put the command here. Ambush. Okay, so now anytime I click this, it executes that command, which generates the ambush user event. Same thing for these other two. So now I've got three click slots here I can click on to make each of the three bars appear. And since these are each of these has a hotkey associated with it, this is by default, this is the one key, the two key, and the three key. But you can change those in your settings. You can change the keys that are assigned to those. Just go to options, key mapping, and find quick slots. It's quick slot 1, 2, and 3. I currently have a one key, two key, and three key assigned to it. And for the other rows, various combinations of control and alt, but you can change those. And if you have an external keypad or a gaming keyboard, you can change the keys that are generated by each of the keys on the device. So it doesn't have to be restricted to something that's convenient for you to type on a regular keyboard. Anyway, so now I've got these hotkeys set up to make the bars appear. The only other thing I want to do is to make the bars move under the mouse cursor when I press the hotkey. So I'm going to add another behavior, move bar under mouse cursor. When user event occurs, self-heal. So anytime I hit the 3 key, it's going to move it under wherever my mouse is. So I'm going to do the same for these other two. Ambush. Adamant behavior. Rescue. Okay, so now with those three keys, no matter where my mouse happens to be, if I want to start that sequence, I just press the corresponding key. A couple of other little refinements. If I push one, but then I change my mind and I don't want to do that sequence, I'm going to add a behavior to make the bar disappear when my mouse goes away from it. So add a behavior, hide bar when mouse departs. So now, see how that works. One other thing. If I click this, and I'm halfway through the sequence, and then I click it again, I want it to not only reappear, but I want it to reset the bar. So I'm going to add that as well. Reset the bar. Name that occurs. Okay, that's about it for this little tutorial.